Hello everyone, now we'll continue the remaining part of the salmonella from enterobacteriaceae. I am Dr. Sharad Deshmukh from SS Jaiswal College, Arjuri Murgaon, District Gondia, Maharashtra. In earlier lecture, in the previous videos, we have seen about the laboratory diagnosis where we learn that how the enteric fever is diagnosed. Now, we'll see how can we control the enteric fever. This is the main aspect of the today's lecture. That is the prophylaxis of the enteric fever. In prophylaxis, in the enteric fever, that can be controlled by the most important aspect, the implementation of the sanitary measures. This is the most important aspect. There should be the personal hygiene as well as the proper sanitation or sanitary measures can definitely help to control these disease caused by the Salmonella species. Second one, most important, is providing the clean and safe water supply. It is particularly the water supply from the municipal source should be clean and safe, and it should be properly done through the supply system, and that will help to prevent the number of the infection caused by the consumption of the water. Mainly, most important is the Salmonella infection. The next is the periodic examination of the cooks and the food handlers which are working in the hostels and the restaurants. This is the most important aspect, where there should be the continuous examination of these cooks and the food handlers, as they may act as a carriers and help to spread the infection. So there should be the periodic examination of these cooks and the food handlers. That will also help to control the Salmonella infection. And last but most important aspect is the vaccination, where we can protect the community from the Salmonella infection. That is the vaccination. So we'll mainly focus on the vaccination. So let us see about the vaccination regarding the Salmonella or the enteric fever. So the first vaccine is the TAB vaccine, and it is the heat killed vaccine. And this vaccine contains mainly the strain of the S typhi, S paratyphi A and S paratyphi B. And it total contains about 1000 million of the S typhi, then 750 million of the S paratyphi A and S paratyphi B per ml of the vaccine. And it is preserved in the 0.5% of the phenol. So it is given in the two doses of 0.5 ml each subcutaneously at an interval of 4 to 6 weeks, and followed by the booster doses every 3 years, and it will give the protection for about 3 to 7 years with the efficacy of the 60 to 80%. That is the heat kill vaccine giving this protection for 3 to 7 years. Now in India, a divalent vaccine is used that is containing only S typhi and S paratyphi A, because I have earlier told that it contained the S typhi and S paratyphi A and B. But in India now only we are using the divalent vaccine, because we know that S paratyphi B is a very rare one. That's why they are not used in this vaccine nowadays. The second vaccine for the enteric fever, that is the live oral vaccine, that is a typhoral vaccine. So it is prepared from the live a virulent mutant strains of the Salmonella typhi, that is the TY21A, and it contains the 1 billionth of the lyophilized S typhi in a capsule. It is in the capsule form, and each capsule will contain about 1 billion of the lyophilized Salmonella typhi. And what are the doses to be given? The three doses are given all alternate days, that is before the food. That is the first day, third day and the fifth day. So three doses should be given, and most important precaution you have to take while taking this vaccine is that no antibiotic should be taken during this period when you are taking this vaccine. It will give the protection of about 65 to 96% for 3 to 5 years, and it is very safe. The next one is the injectable vaccine, that is Typhim VI. So it is prepared from the VI polysaccharide antigen. So it contains the purified VI polysaccharide antigen, and in the dose of 25 microgram per dose. It is from the S. typhi TY2 strain. So it is prepared from the Salmonella typhi TY2 strain, where you have to use the VI polysaccharide antigen in the dose of 25 microgram per dose. Here you have to give the only a single dose is sufficient, and it is given about the 0.5 ml intramuscularly, and 0.5 ml will contain the 25 microgram of the VI polysaccharide antigen. It is 75% efficient and give the well protection. This was about the prophylaxis. Thank you.